Hello out there, it's Mama Bear here. I am coming to you with another YouTube video on the Civcraft server. Today I want to show you everything that has to do with a windmill. So a windmill is my most favourite building ever. Let me just rescue Hayden. He seems to be having issues with the rain ruining his hairdo. So basically a windmill is like my most favoritest building ever, purely because manually seeding a really large farm takes forever, especially when in Civcraft we do multi-level farms to take advantage of space, and it's more efficient essentially, but it still takes a very, very long time. So until you get a windmill, it's a very long hard slog. So in the where are we? In spawn bottom, where we are, I keep on wanting to say BFF, and I also keep on wanting to say Benjamin's button, so Benja's button, so I kind of might need to get Savvy to change us back to Benja's button, because I keep wanting to say that. Not the point. The point is, in our city state at the moment, we had our three farms here, so it was, I'm just up on a pillar at the moment, and we had three farms in a row of one. What you can see I have done now is I have actually expanded this out to another five farms. So this means I have 8 farms in total all around where my windmill is, which is underneath this block. So of course you can't build buildings on top of buildings, so we can't build a windmill on top of a farm or a farm on top of a windmill, so this center block is essentially void. It does mean that when you build above the windmill, nothing will actually seed there. I've sort of failed in building that. I think it was not last phase we decided to put the windmill in the middle of the farms, but it actually, because I started the farm so low down, it actually went up through the farm, and we essentially lost the two farms at either end of the windmill, because the auto harvest, which is flowing this way on my farm, was actually getting stuck around the windmill, and everything was basically getting stuck and not flowing through down into the hoppers, so we were losing it. So we ended up pulling out those farms. It was a massive waste of energy. So this time I have played it a little bit better, thought about it a little bit more. So then over this side here, we've got another row of three farms, and what I'm actually going to do is put a windmill over that side there. So if you can get this vision in your mind, I essentially want a row of three farms, a windmill, a row of three farms, a windmill, a row of three farms, a windmill, and I will take advantage of the farms on either end, because we are placing our windmill underneath our farms. You can see here I've got my actual farm plots on the surface. That's kind of messed us up a little bit, because it means that we can't take advantage of the gradient. Like when you build your farm up like that, we're sort of chewing into, we're sort of stuck, we've reached a level here, and I'll show you when we go below. So ultimately what I think you should be doing with your actual farm buildings is putting them up high, above 90, and they're just basically useless blocks at the top, or they are useless blocks on the very bottom, so you want them down low, basically below 30, remembering that you can't actually plant anything on them. So we've not done that, that's fine, we're working around it. So when you do yours in next phase, I'm assuming that the restrictions with the height still going to remain next phase, or if you're starting out afresh, then you guys can come up with the best way that you want to handle that. Why are there holes there? Strange. Oh no, that's right. So as you can see here, I filled in the water holes, and the reason why I've done that is because I don't want the hoed ground, like I don't want this to be available, because what that means is the windmill will actually seed this plot. Okay, it's dried up, that's good. So I essentially don't want my windmill to seed anything up here. It does slow down the windmill. Also, if you are building, if you've got your farm buildings on the bottom and you are building up your gradient, you're building it up, and there is hoed area, toiled area, tilled area, toiled area underneath in like a dark little recess. The windmill will constantly seed that piece of that little square. Like if you've got one of these and it's sort of like hiding in a corner and you can't see it, the windmill will constantly be seeding this, and you'll just lose a whole bunch of seed. It's waste of money, so or waste of seed. So please make sure that you take your water out. And the other thing, oh here we can you see it's already seeded. The other thing that you can do is place like dirt or sand on top of it, and then that will actually stop it from being able to be grown on. So that's something to bear in mind there. So one of the reasons why I have placed my farms down here with not being well, not actually building them at the moment, is because I A don't have enough hammers, and B I also wanted to use these as markers for my windmill, this second windmill, which I wanted to show you in this video. So we can see here on the bottom left that this is just an owned area, and this is an actual farm. So that just sort of helps block that out. Also, farm plots don't automatically claim. So you'll see here that this chunk here is owned by Mini Bear. This chunk here is owned by Mama Bear. So you can see that there, but I have actually auto claimed that chunk purely for the purpose of being able to see when I am no longer on that chunk. Then that way I've got the same thing up here. This chunk up here that this farm is on is not actually claimed, but this one is down the bottom here. So I can see that this here is where my windmill is going to go. So essentially, these farms are placeholders, and I'll show you how that works out down below. So I'm just going to get into our admin center here, and I might offload some stuff. Always offload stuff, because if you accidentally die, you'll be very upset with yourself. And I might actually keep. Fill up on torches. Don't think I'm going to need that many hammers. Two, three, four, five, six, and a bit. Think that's right. I am actually going to drop some food off to my alt. So my alt is here. Just chunk loading the farm. So I'll show you. She's got no food on us, so I'll just give her some food here. There you go. So I'll show you. This is the top level of our farm. Now the reason why it's not good, or well, why it's better to have your farm at the top of above 90 or below 30, is because we've done it in the middle, which means that I am now at 67. So I've got like another 20 odd levels to go, and I've reached the max because up here, this is the farm up here. So the below chunk that you can see there, the below farm, the back farm, actually does go right up to this farm, which is great. But then I had all this wide open space that wasn't being utilized, so I actually went off and built like a half farm to take advantage of this extra space here. So yeah, best of a bad situation, I guess you could say. We didn't really plan it very well, but that's just something that we've done. That's why it looks a bit odd there. So again, yes, I recommend building your buildings above your farm buildings above 90 or below 30, and doing it that way as opposed to in the middle somewhere, or just don't go any higher or lower. It's up to you. So these are my three farms. If you've watched my other videos, you'll see that I have four levels. Well, ooh, wow, that's like a one heart drop. Didn't realize that, because it's now five levels. I've done that half level. So the windmill is seeding this farm here. I don't have anything over here, so it's not going to be seeding anything there. So yeah, I'm just gonna recover some hearts. This is going to be my collection level. I'm essentially going to collect all the wheat and seeds from all the farms, and then I'm going to feed it down here to a bakery. Somewhere around here, I'm going to feed it to a bakery, and Then I'm also going to feed it out to the other windmill. So the windmill is going to be down. So at the moment we are on 34, and the windmill actually is built further down. So I have hoppers and chests to go down to the windmill that I do have in place. And I've used hoppers and chests to go straight into the windmill. So I've blocked off the entrance so we can't get in. But you will see that there is hoppers going all the way to a secondary chest that I have that is then fed by a hopper into the main chest itself. So what I've done is before I started this video, I did actually plant. Oh, there's gold. I did actually plan to take this gold. That's the other great thing about building underground is that when you put these structures in, they tend to reveal a lot. So I do have to admit, I did start this video after I trialed it. So we will see when we go down here. holes because I've already mined all the goodies out of it. So anyway, so this is the farm. So if you, sorry, this is the windmill. So if you remember the farm structure, this is in the middle. So I've got my three farms up this way. I have one here that hasn't actually been built yet, and also one at the other end of the windmill that hasn't been built yet, and also over this side. So if we watch here, the change in ownership. So this one is owned by Minnie, this one is owned by Mama. That is the next row of three farms that again I haven't built yet. So I want my windmill to go out on the other side of those three farms. So if we move out here, we'll see here that again this is when I hit the wilderness. So this is the row of farms, and this is where my windmill row is going to go. So it's not a really a row of windmills. I guess you could, if you had enough money, you could do a row of windmills. That would seed it quite quickly, but and that's a little bit OP, I'm guessing. Cool. So I am a subscriber, so I do have my chunk align enabled. There we go. Now it's enabled. And if we just go into build a structure, build a windmill, normal template. And there's our windmill there. So we can see it's right on the border, which is what I want it to be. And yes, I told you I had planned it, and it was actually here. I did actually notice as well that the windmill did auto align, chunk align. So I guess it's because the farms do it as well. I'm not sure. Anyway, so this is the preview. So yes, this is exactly where I want it to go. I know that this is the border between the chunks, and this is also the border between those chunks. So let's place it. Yes, to place. Now where's my chest? Here it is. Okay, so again, I told you we are building underground. Something red flashed over there. So yeah, so this is, there was some redstone here. I stole that. There was diamonds here. I already stole that. I think the redstone must have come out here, which is what that red flash was, because the building chewed it up. So you do end up missing out on a little bit there. But anyway, it doesn't highlight very well. Let's see. That was lame. So you can see it goes up quite high. Yeah, oh, there's gold. Should I mission for it? What have I got? I don't think I have enough sand. Oh, I do. Hi. Cool bananas. So we are going to grow this windmill. So one thing is the structure is valid. The hammers required is 450. I'm just going to chuck all these in, and it still needs another two. Oh, isn't that sad? Okay, I'll be back. So I was actually going to go all the way back up to get my two hammers, and then I saw the coal. So I'm just going to steal the coal and hopefully pick up Two hammers. There we go. Chala. Cool. Two hammers. Done and done. So this is going to build the windmill. So while the windmill is constructing, I'll just fill you in on some boring stats. For starters, the windmill is a 1x1 chunk, so only one chunk is required to build the windmill. It does require the machinery tech. So on the tech tree, you will need to research the, which one is it? The agriculture, is it? No, you will need to research hunting first, then you will need to research masonry, which is your tier 2 tech. And the windmill is a tier 3 tech with machinery. So you will need to research those first. And then once you get your windmill, it's going to cost you 500 coins a day in upkeep and about 100, well, the website says 100 hammers to grow, but at the moment it's now actually 450 because we are in version 2.4.1. So the windmill will actually replant seeds, potatoes and carrots. So depending on what you put in, depends on what it spits out. So I noticed in last phase that by the time that the last farm had been, always have to celebrate the little wins. By the time that the last farm had actually been seeded, the first farm had actually fully grown. So what I'm going to do with this particular windmill is on these farms here, when I grow those, when I build them, I'm going to actually insert carrots and potatoes, I think, into this windmill here. So I'm going to have hoppers coming down that will auto feed into here. Which means that I have a lot of mining and whatnot to do. So similar setup to these guys here that go into the seed chest that's at the back and just feed the seeds through, or feed the carrots and potatoes through from my harvesting area up the top. So hopefully that makes it a little bit more detailed for you. I don't recall claiming the plot. Now that the windmill's finished, one thing that I have noticed is that it has not claimed the chunk. The chunk is not claimed. Like a farm, it does not actually claim the chunk. So whether this is an oversight, I'm not sure, but we will need to claim this, otherwise people will be able to come in and destroy and access anything that's in here because there's no permission. So I'm going to set my permissions now. First of all, I'm going to, there's several ways of claiming your chunks, but this is the way I do it. And then I set the permissions. Now there is only Wasabi and I, so I just go to the permissions simple option and just go 1, 2, 3, and it has set my permissions to government only. That means that if anyone does decide to join us, we just leave them as a resident, and then they can't access the buildings until we give them access to the actual government group, not government group, the advisors group or the leaders group, or we create a new one and give them access to the individual buildings. So that's just how we do it. So we can see here now that the plot is claimed, and if I double check the map, yep, so the chunk has now come up as claimed. So that's building a windmill. I'm going to put some hoppers and whatnot along this path as well, like here, to auto sort of fill up the chest at the back there. And I might be putting some potatoes and carrots in there just to sort of start getting a few of those up and running. So I'm going to, from our collection area on the farms up here, I'm probably going to have another drop area off to this side along here, which will be like I will manually put the in things down into chests like this that will then seed down into the farm. So that's building a windmill, and I hope you found that informative and useful, and please leave a like if you did, so that I know that this video, these videos are actually helping you out. And also, if you have any questions, put them into the comments, or I will see you online. So thanks for watching and see you online.